Yeah, I was in the hills all
night. Sweating, got a lot of thoughts and mixed emotions. Got me thinking about life and me in general and everyone there at the wedding. So happy, love, other parents there, mothers, fathers, all standing up and saying how thankful they are for their kids. And I started noticing about the fathers and the mothers, how they're really proud of their sons and daughter, and how they're a lot like them. And I started thinking, and I wonder how much am I like my dad? And I'm more like him than I think that I'd want to be. Back in therapy last week, I was asking my therapist, do I think there's anything good about my dad? And I honestly couldn't say. Maybe. I'm sure some people thought it was good. I don't know what. I think he probably put on a nice show. It wasn't good to me. So that got me thinking, what kind of man would be like that? What kind of person would want to be like that? And then she asked me, do you think there's anything that I wish or he wished he could have changed before he passed? Before he killed himself. And I sat there and thought, maybe he should have done it sooner. Because I've noticed he hasn't had much down to me. Except for my facial hair and fucking mental problems. I notice I'm kind of fucking crazy like he is. Or was. I'm self-destructive. I sabotage anything that's good in my life. And that's kind of what he did. Didn't care about anybody but himself, as far as I'm aware. But back to my therapist asked me what he could have done earlier, and I sat there and thought about it. And maybe all I could come up with is off the shelf quicker before he made me. So once again, he had something good in his life, and he crushed it. Often himself, so he had no responsibilities in protecting or molding me as a man, or protecting me from future people in my life, or teach me how to be a man. And you know, thanks for fucking nothing. I'm afraid that I'm becoming the man that I hate. Man that I hated. Seems my life is falling apart around me, and so is his. All the time. And I wonder if he was even really a good person. I think I'm a good person. Down to it, maybe I'm not. That's a hard pill to swallow. I do things that I don't know why. When something good happens to me, I crush it. job, house, whatever, I can't seem to fucking help but to sabotage myself. You know, I had a huge breakdown this last year. I ruined everything I had. I'm still recovering from it. And all I can think of is thanks for fucking nothing. And I can understand why he wouldn't want to live with himself any longer than he did. Who would want to live like that, knowing you're a piece of shit? The whole side of his family never claimed me. Always been kind of a loner. My mom did the best she could, and I love her to death for it. They're going through therapy, and they should learn a lot of things about yourself. A lot of things that you don't like, and you try to change. Sometimes I'm scared that I won't ever change those things. I work on myself every day. But maybe I am that monster. The monster that I grew up fucking hating. I sure hope not. Fucking weddings. Get a lot of emotions going through you. I really don't know what else to say. It's just kind of my mind this whole trip. And I don't know. Anxiety, self-destructive, self-medication. If you ask me, you think your father is self-medicated? Fuck yeah, he's self-medicated. It's a fucking mental case. I'm my father. As much as I try not to be. You know, I don't want to be him. Be a coward, someone that doesn't do what they know is right, someone that sabotages shit that's good. Fucking nothing. they make those mistakes. So they finally go, fuck you.